Hello! Today I'm going to talk to you about the new drum sampler from Toontrack called EZDrummer 2. And rather than being just a drum sampler, it puts a lot more emphasis on the songwriting aspect in this version than before. And I'm going to briefly show you what you can do with the plugin and what I do and how I use it to create drum tracks for my own songs. So this is my Logic project, where I already have come up with a couple of riffs. Got the left guitar, right guitar, bass guitar, and the center guitar. Sounds like this. It's just a basic verse, pre-chorus, and a chorus. And then the verse again. And I want to make a complete drum track for this particular song. And this is where EZDrummer 2 really shines. Rather than using the MIDI pen to write in beats manually, now using the browser and the search function, you can find grooves yourself using different filters like genre and time signatures, etc. But I'm going to use the tap to find function within the plugin to quickly find a beat that fits the guitar riff I wrote. The verse riff. Basically, I just tap a beat myself with the click of the mouse. So it's and you can keep on adding parts of the kit as the loop goes, like this. You get the idea. I'm gonna keep this simple, so I'll remove the ride and the crash and the toms. So when you got the idea done, you press show results, and EZDrummer 2 will show you the grooves that fit the beat you wanted the most. So let's hear them. This has a 95% match. This one has 93% match. I think this one is the one that sounds close to what I want, so I'll use this one. So I'll just drag it down to the board here. And when I've dragged the groove down to the board, I can edit its play style. By double clicking, and here you have it. Listen to it. You can change the opening hit if you want to a ride or a crash. You can change the power hand. And also another thing I can do is that I can add hits to different parts. So if I want more kick hits, I used to add them here. Even more. And what's awesome with this feature is that you can basically copy the same groove and just change them up just a bit to make the drum track more dynamic and not too repetitive. And if I mark them here, I can also adjust the velocity. But I can also adjust the velocity of different parts if I want to. But mainly I was just here to change the power hand, so, and I changed it from the hi-hat to one of the crashes to make the groove heavier. Okay, so let's listen to what we have.
I
Sounds pretty heavy. Okay, so the drum beat is cool. I got the drum beat for the verse, and I want to base the whole song around this groove. I just open the song creator. I drag the groove into the MIDI drop zone. And the song creator will analyze and create song parts for you based on your initial beat. So here we have suggested intros, verses, pre-choruses, chorus, bridge, fills. You got a lot of them, and the endings, etc. So, okay, to continue the song, I want another verse groove. Change the power hand here. Okay, so let's check out the... And next is the pre-chorus, and for the pre-chorus riff, I will want something with a ride on it to just change the dynamics a bit. So let's find a groove. This sounds pretty good. So I'll just open that up and drag it down here. Open the play style. Change the power hand to a ride. Let's just put in a fill. Before the chorus. So put that in there. And you can also add hits to the fills if you want to. If you even want more snare hits. And then we have the chorus. I want something that's heavy. That sounds cool. That one too. So that's the chorus. And then... pretty good. Then after the chorus, we're going back to the verse again, so we'll grab a verse riff here. And there you have it, a complete and dynamic sounding drum track created in less than 5 minutes.